But for Russian President Vladimir Putin, Russia would only emerge stronger as soon as it overcomes challenges caused by Western sanctions. Here's the full story.
Russian President Vladimir Putin warned on Thursday that Russia would ultimately emerge stronger and more independent after the West imposed what he called illegitimate sanctions. Addressing a government meeting, Putin also said Moscow, which is a major energy producer, would continue to meet its contractual obligations. And he said that Western sanctions would prove self-defeating.
Мы с вами хорошо знаем, они призывают своих граждан затянуть пояса.
We know it well. They urge their citizens to tighten their belts, dress warmer, and point to the sanctions they impose on us as a reason for their deteriorating situation.
Hitting back against the West, the Russian government said earlier it had banned exports of telecoms, medical, auto, agriculture, electrical and tech equipment, among other items, until the end of the year. In total, over 200 items were included on the export suspension list, which also covered railway cars, containers and turbines. Earlier on Thursday, Kremlin spokesman Dmitry Peskov also said that Russia's economy was experiencing a shock and that measures were being taken to soften the blow from the raft of far-reaching sanctions.
The situation is totally unprecedented. The economic war that has started against our country has never taken place before. So it is very hard to forecast anything. One needs not to forecast, but to act to minimize the negative consequences and further risks.
The UK sanctioned 7 more oligarchs it links to the Kremlin on Thursday. That follows 14 sanctioned by the EU on Wednesday.
The war in Ukraine and massive sanctions against Russia will force the International Monetary Fund to lower its global growth forecast for this year. IMF Managing Director Kristalina Georgieva says the conflict has triggered a contraction in global trade, sending food and energy prices sharply higher. She adds the surge in inflation triggered by the war could accelerate monetary policy tightening in many countries.
So we got through a crisis like no other with the pandemic, and we are now in an even more shocking territory. The unthinkable happened. We have a war in Europe. We are mindful that massive currency depreciation is driving inflation up. It is denting severely the purchasing power and standard of living for a vast majority of the Russian population. Spillovers to neighboring countries are also significant.
The global lender had already lowered its global growth forecast to 4.4% this year from 4.9%. The IMF will release its updated world economic outlook next month. As the West tries to stop Russia's aggression in Ukraine, the U.S. is also keeping a close eye on the rogue state of North Korea following its recent satellite tests. Washington suspects Pyongyang may be testing a new intercontinental ballistic missile.
North Korean leader Kim Jong-un has called to expand the country's space rocket launch site, according to state media KCNA on Friday. They reported that Kim announced this during a visit to the Sohae Satellite Launching Ground, which has been used to fire satellites that experts say use similar tech to intercontinental ballistic missiles. KCNA quoted Kim saying, "It is the noble duty to turn the launching ground associated with our state's great dream and ambition for a space power into an ultra-modern advanced base and a starting line of space conquest for the future." Friday's report comes after South Korea and the U.S. jointly declared that the North's two most recent satellite tests used a new ICBM and further suggested Pyongyang could possibly fire a missile under the guise of launching a space vehicle. Its latest launch earlier this month was North Korea's 9th weapons test of the year. Washington described the ICBM tests as a, quote, serious escalation requiring a united global response. The missile system in question is known as the Hwasong-17 and was unveiled at an October 2020 military parade in Pyongyang. A U.S. official said tests have likely been designed to check elements of the system before a full-range firing, potentially disguised as a space launch banned by the U.N. Security Council. Kim has defended satellite work as protecting North Korea's sovereignty, exercising its rights to self-defense, and elevating national prestige.